We invited Chief Meteorologist Lisa Teachman to our school to give the kids some hands-on learning instead of just always being in the classroom. We are doing a project with project-based learning over storms. Our unit in Journeys, the story was storms. So we're learning about meteorologists and weather predicting and how that can help us stay safe if there was a storm to come.
My name is Lisa Teachman and I'm the Chief Meteorologist at KSNW. So if you guys are watching Channel 3 tonight at 5, 6, or 10, I'm going to be doing the weather. And did you know that when I was your age, I was so scared of storms? How many of you are scared of storms? Raise your hand. That's a lot of you. How many of you are scared of the tornado sirens? How many of you are scared of tornadoes?
This is something new we're going to try this year, where we're going to bring community leaders to our school, because we can't always take the students on a field trip every week or every month. So our goal is to get as many community members involved in coming to our school to give hands-on presentations.
What we're going to talk today a little bit is about weather patterns. We're going to talk about severe weather and how to stay safe. This is a weather center on wheels. I could be at KSN or I could be here anywhere within the country, and I can actually use internet to get all this information. But that stick right there, that white stick, I know it looks a lot different than probably what you guys have been looking at in your books of what a thermometer looks like and what an anemometer looks like. But the new technology puts everything together. We also have another camera up on top. You guys see what looks almost like a little ghost?
Yeah.
That can actually rotate completely around. We have weather instruments that are patched into the top.
I think giving them the opportunity to see that real life people exist and do these jobs is going to give them a purpose and a goal and help them look at their future and want to pursue some of these careers.
I was actually born in Wichita and I was raised down the road in Hayesville. See my shoes? You know what these are? These are actually radar images. In order for a tornado to happen, several things have to happen in the atmosphere. And the chances of you seeing a tornado or being hit by a tornado are pretty low, even for living in Kansas. There are three things that you should grab if you only have seconds. Number one, grab a pillow. Why do you grab a pillow? Well, you want to protect your head. Number two, grab a blanket. You're going to use the blanket and you're going to actually put it around you because that will also protect you from debris. And number three, see what I have on my feet? You want to have shoes.
We had a great day and I think the kids had fun learning and enjoying outside, not always in the classroom.
A few days ago, we watched your channel.
You watched my channel? Great. Keep watching.
I watched you too.
Good.